in the, tell the tenor to stop singing. There you go. Thank you. By the way, if you were wondering, that album is three Irish tenors, which we found at Barnes & Noble. Well, here's a fellow you don't get to hear sing by himself every day, but he is a hoot. Lou Kelly has been a member of our choir ever since I can remember, and, well, longer than that, I don't really remember much, but anyway. And he is going to regale you with the lyrics from The Irish Rover, and he is accompanied tonight by a lady who's just become involved in our music ministry to a little degree here, Miss Kathy Finney.
Before I start, I gotta tell you, we're gonna do a song called The Irish Rover. And this is the commemoration of a fine sailing ship. The Irish Rover was a magnificent sailing ship which carried cargo primarily between County Cork and America, New York, Boston, and Charleston. She was built around the time of the American Revolution. She had 23 masts. Although some say the 27, she had a colorful crew, well-trained and experienced and hand-leader, and a capable captain. These men had worked together for years. They sailed the North Atlantic all year long, summer and winter. And this is a challenge even today, but they always came through successfully. In 1813, the good ship and crew were lost in a violent storm due to a heavy fall. The crew had contracted measles, and all but one of the crewmen and the captain's dog had died. The ship was too much to handle for one man. It hit a rock, turned over, and sank, and there was only one survivor. In the year of our Lord, 1806, we set sail from the cold Cay of Cork. We were sailing in style with a cargo of brick for the grand city hall in New York. With an elegant craft was rigged fore and aft, and how the trade winds drove her. We had 23 masts, she stood several class, and we called her the Irish Rover. Okay, now that's the ship, and you got a good idea of what the ship was like. Now we're going to go to the crew. We had Barney McGee from the banks of the Lee. We had Hogan from County Tyrone. We had Johnny McGurk, who was scared stiff of work, and a lad from West Mead named Malone. There was Sir O'Toole, he was drunk as a rule, and fighting Bill Tracy from Dover, and your man, Big McCann, on the banks of the man, was the skipper on the Ivory Throne. Okay, now that takes care of the ship and the crew. Oh, the manifest. There we go to the manifest. 1, 2, 3, 4. We had 1 billion bags of the best Sligo rags. We had 2 billion barrels of stones. We had 3 billion sides, all fine horses' hides. We had 4 billion barrels of gold. We had 5 million hogs, 7, 6 million dogs, 7 million barrels of porter. We had 9 billion men, full of many eagle tails in the hold of the Irish Rover. Okay, we got the ship, we got the crew, we got the man. Oh, now we go to the log. The fateful last journey of the Irish Rover. Well, we sailed 7 years till the measles broke out and the ship lost her way in a flood. Then the weight of the crew was reduced down to 2 when myself and the captain's old dog. Then the struck the rock. Oh Lord, what a shock.
It's called Gavotte, and please welcome Miss Alexandria Holman. Ministry playing in the parts in the Easter play and then in the Christmas play, and now he's going to be in the Easter play again. And he also has a beautiful voice. He loves to sing. His name is Mariano Bula, and he is going to be singing Mary, Don't You Weep. And we invite you to snap along as we get his rhythm. Come on up, Mariano.
And for those those who are not familiar with this song, it's a combination of the story of Mary and Martha losing their brother, knowing that Jesus will bring him back to life in the New Testament, and also in the Old Testament, Moses trying to free his people from the Egyptians, while the Egyptians ended up drowning in the Red Sea. But Once and For All is a very, very popular song. It has a beat in it. And for those who are very familiar with the song and the lyrics behind it, feel free to sing the chorus for me. The name of that is Oh Mary, Don't You Weep.
If I could, I surely would stand on the rock where Moses stood. Pharaoh's army got around it. Oh Mary, don't you weep. Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Pharaoh's army got around it. Oh Mary, don't you weep. Mary worked 3 lengths of chain, every lean where Jesus came. Pharaoh's army got around it. Oh Mary, don't you weep. One of those nights about 12 o'clock, this whole world's going to reel and rock. Pharaoh's army got around it. Oh Mary, don't you weep. Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Pharaoh's army got around it. Oh Mary, don't you weep. God tell Moses what to do to lead Hebrew children through. And Pharaoh's army got round it. Oh Mary, don't you weep. Moses stood on the Red Sea shore, smiting the water with 2 by 4. Pharaoh's army got round it. Oh Mary, don't you weep. Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Pharaoh's army got round it. Oh Mary, don't you weep. God gave Moses the rainbow sign, no more water, but fire next time. Pharaoh's army got round it. Oh Mary, don't you weep. Mary wore 3 lengths of chain, every lean was freedom's name. Pharaoh's army got round it. Oh Mary, don't you weep. Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Pharaoh's army got round it. Oh Mary, don't you weep. It may be right, may be wrong. I know you're gonna miss me when I'm gone. Pharaoh's army got round there. Oh Mary, don't you weep. There you are. Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Oh Mary, don't you weep, don't you mourn. Pharaoh's army got round there. Oh Mary, don't you weep.
Comes up and takes the stage and gets settled in because they have a little plugging in to do and such as that. I'd like to take a few moments to thank some very special people who helped me to assemble our part of this evening, and that is Mary and Glenn White and Rob Ayu, who helped set up the sound. Spent all day Thursday, almost a couple of all day Thursday, and they're of course taking care of it tonight, running the sound and taking care of everything, even when I couldn't be here when I was at Mass. Thank you so much. And I'd like to thank those who helped with the decorating this afternoon. Stand up. I know Carolyn is here. Who else? Andrew. Gosh. better to help challenge or disarm the rally. Thank you. Appreciate it. Okay, we're going to do our first drawing, too, for our first door prize. Let me go find it. Did you get a ticket? No, I've got to put my glasses on. I cannot read this fine print. One more time, 8, 8, 6, 7, 55. No, onward. 0, 8, 8, 6, 9, 1, 7. 6, 9, 1, 7. All right, this ensemble, most of you have seen their faces a lot. You especially see our singer, Ruth Lindgren, her daughters, Shannon playing piano, and Tara playing the keyboard, and her soon-to-be son-in-law, Kaylin McCormick, playing the guitar. And they were going to play for you a beautiful song that we used a lot of years ago called The Rose.
I don't mind. free and wild. But I got cat class and I got cast out.
Okay, our next performer you saw just a little earlier. Now, I told you that she started playing violin when she was 3. She also started to tap dance when she was 3. So please welcome Alexander Holman doing Shim, Sham, Shimmy. All right, before we go on, I have our second drawing. There's a legend about St. Bridget with apples in it, and I have forgotten, because it's been so many years I had forgotten, so I had to look it up, and this morning I looked it up. And basically, the legend of the apples was this. A nun gave Bridget, who was, I guess she was an abbess at the time, I don't know what she was at the time, but anyway, she became an abbess, and she accepted them, and some lepers in the community were very hungry, and they said, they asked St. Bridget if they could have, have some of her apples, and so she gave them all away, and that was what she did a lot of. She was very generous in her life, and so the nun got mad at her and said, those weren't for them, they were for you. And so Bridget basically said, well, your apple trees aren't going to grow any more apples for a long time. So another nun offered her some more apples, and she also shared them with the lepers, and the nun, that one was wise. And she said, yeah, go ahead and give them to everybody, you know. So her apple trees were fruitful and multiplied. So this is a basket of apples, or more correctly, a bowl of apples of different varieties, and we need to... So, I have ticket number 8867-4545. I'm hearing a roar in the crowd. Okay! there are fewer people that you see more of in the music industry than these folks up here, especially two of them. And I'd like to thank Mary and Glenn again for all the work that they do at the 10:30 Mass and other Masses and for many other things. And Fernando Rivera is joining them on the congas, right? And they're going to perform a really neat Beatles tune called Till There Was You.
Initially, it was Anita Bryant in the 1950s, and so the premise of the song is that many of us see ordinary things every day, but they don't mean anything until you're in love. And so this is kind of a song, hopefully you'll find it kind of romantic.
It's so much better when you're in the same key, you know what I mean? Okay.